All right. All right. So for today's build, we are going to be doing two mini circuits of three exercises. So three exercises at the top half of the workout, three exercises in the bottom half of the workout. Each one is going to have a 15-minute running clock. So 15 minutes for the top three, 15 minutes for the bottom three. And for each exercise, we are doing five reps for it. Okay, so everything is five. If you ever forget, and we're just going through it as many times as we can, and it's build. So the idea is challenge your strength with this. So with that, the first three, the first one is a single arm kettlebell clean is what we're doing in the large group. So if you don't have a kettlebell, it'll be a single arm dumbbell clean, but a single arm clean nonetheless. So kettlebell or dumbbell, for five on each side. Then it'll be, and I'll show you that. With a kettlebell, that'll just be, all right. So it's palm facing me, and then I'm kind of cleaning to a rack position, with a dumbbell, which is here, and then kind of racking it to the shoulder, kind of using the jump to carry it up there. So that one's not, we do those all the time. Cleans, major things on that is just keep your core tight. Since it is single set, not letting it kind of twist you, trying not to let it torque too much on your spine. So keep that core tight. Then the next one is a single arm squat, whether or not you have a kettlebell or dumbbell, it depends on what your equipment is. But if you have a kettlebell, it's racked up like this. Squatting here, trying to keep it racked nice and high for, once again, five on each side. Same thing with the dumbbell. Just if you have a dumbbell, I'd have you kind of rack it out in front of you like this. These are both going to, force you to really squeeze your core tight. And it should be a really good challenge, and should really challenge your core as well as your legs, obviously, since they're both leg exercises. But so those are the first two. Second one is going to be a squeeze press. So if squeeze press is not going to work with your equipment, you can do a regular chest press. But a squeeze press with a bridge hold. So all that is a couple aspects to it. So a squeeze press is where you have both your weights and you are here and you're pressing your weights into each other. So I'm pressing together while they're on my chest. And then I'm squeezing them together the entire time as I'm coming forward. I'm on my back. I'll be on my back when I'm doing this. But I'm just kind of showing you kind of like the frontal view of this. So they're squeezing in the entire time as I'm pressing out from me. So when I'm on the ground, I'll be down. I'll have myself bridged. Have my weights together, squeezing them together, up in my bridge. And I'm pressing like that. And we'll go nice and slow for five of those, okay? So with these, the squeeze is important if you can do it. I know sometimes with weights, it's hard to do it if you don't have like a hexagon weights, sometimes like the circular, like at home weights can be tough to squeeze together. If that's the case, just do a slow motion chest press for those. And that'll be just fine. Awesome. So that's the first three. So clean, single arm squat, and then kind of that squeeze press or chest press, floor press, whatever you want to call it. And then the next three, single arm bent over row. So for that, we love these bent over rows. So we're here, bent over hinged, And we are rowing core tight. 4, 5 on this side, 5 on the other side. Once again, trying to use our core as much as we can. If your low back's feeling unstable, unsteady, like it's getting too much torque, you can, you know, use your other hand a little bit to support while you're doing it. I recommend eventually working towards not doing it, but always listen to your body. All right. So that's the first one. The second one is those rows. The second one is reverse lunges. So it's just here. And then stepping back, stepping through. Nothing fancy. Weight is in the same side as the leg that is stepping back. All right. So 5 of those on each side. Dumbbell or kettlebell. And then lateral drags is the last one. So you're starting in a push-up position and you're dragging your weight across your body. So what that can look like here with a kettlebell. I'll show you what a kettlebell. We're in this push-up position. I don't think you can see the weight. Let me move some stuff. All right. So we are up in our push-up position. We're dragging our weight across our body, flipping it over and going side to side. You can do the same thing with a dumbbell, just turning it like this, and I don't know if you can even see it still, it's hard to see. And you just drag it across. All right, trying to keep your hips level, trying to go nice and slow across to really work your obliques. And those that'll be the second three, all right?
I'm actually counting 4. I got squeeze press, single arm bent over row, reverse lunges, and lateral drags.
So the squeeze presses are the last one of the first circuit of 3.
All right. Well, the first circuit, I had the kettlebell swing, the single arm clean, and the single
arm clean. There's no swing on that one. Just a clean. So clean is the first one. Second one is squat. Third one is squeeze press.
Got it. Okay.
Good question. I guess I wouldn't be opposed if you did some kettlebell swings beforehand, but that's not what I had. So that's that would be extra credit. Awesome. Good. Glad to know you're listening. all right. So now we'll get warmed up. So now we're just gonna start loosening ourselves up. I'll have us start with a figure 4 stretch here, and then we'll get going. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, switch. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Woo. All right, good. After that, I'm going to have us do kind of our side-to-side knee drops here. We'll do 10 of these on each side. Good job. All right, after those, I'm going to have us do side lion windmills. So those ones, you're lying on your side. and you are kind of tucking the knees, tracing that top arm up, over, and around. Five on each side. All right. Good. Once you're done with those, I am going to have you doing some Spider-Man with elbow drop. So it'll be kind of in that push-up position, step, elbow drop, and switch, step, elbow drop, switch. Five of those on each side. After those, I'm going to have us come up. I'll do five staggered stance hamstring stretches. Good. After that, I'll have us do 10 on each side, overhead reverse lunges. Once you're done with those, I'm gonna have us do single leg hops. We'll do side to side after you're done with all 10 on each side of those. Go. All right, then we'll do front and back, 10 on each side. 7, 8, 9, 10, 10. And then 25 jumping jacks. There you go, that's 25. All right. Okay. All right, so yeah, like I was saying, single arm kettlebell clean, single arm kettlebell squat, and single arm, and then squeeze press, all right, for those first three. So I'll get our timer started here. 15 solid minutes of this, and then we'll move on. This will be a challenge for sure. All right. Awesome. All right, starting here in 10 with our equipment. Good. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1,
go.
All right. Jacqueline, we got slots. Go. And then chest presses, here we go. The more you squeeze the weights together, if you can, the harder your chest works. All right, then once we're done that, back to the beginning. Whew. All right. All right. It's gonna be a lot of rounds. All right. Oh.
All right. All right, 9.5 minutes to go. Here you go. Hardest part of these squats. Core's got to be crazy tight for these. All right. Good job. Back and forth, guys. We got about 7 minutes, 10 seconds to go. Still a good amount of time on these. Let me know. It's the more I go. 4.5 minutes. Keep it up, Carl.
You've lost it all, unsure of what the future holds. Now I can hear your call tonight. To turn back now.
All right, 3 minutes, 20 seconds to go. At least enough time for a full morning round. All right.
Towards a brand new life.
A minute 24 left. Twenty seconds left. Five, four, three. Rest. That's it. All right. Woo. Okay. Ah, nice. Okay. I'm glad we didn't have kettlebell swings in with that too. next three, single arm bent over row, contralateral reverse lunge, lateral kettlebell drag. All right, let's get them. Man, it's hot. All right. Get this clock restarted. I was not doing it. There we go. All right. Starting here in 10, starting with our bent over rows. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and go. All right, reverse lunge. Is that really what it is? Oh my gosh.
Now you're thinking you're the only one, but you gotta wish you never met her. Daddy told me don't go out with a loaded gun. She's a beast, it's too late. Darling, she's a beast.
All right, then lateral kettlebell drag. Oh my gosh. If you're bracing your core on these rows, back nice and flat. Yeah. Oh.
Here we go.
All right, 10 minute mark right here. These ones don't take long, but they really wear you out. All right, back to your rows when you're ready. Since this is a build, it's okay if you're having a little bit more rest than you normally would for, like, say, a burn or something like that, just because we're hoping that we're building up that ATP here so we're able to give full effort to whatever we're doing. Here we go.
Dancing in the strong blue from the sky, just you and I. And your eyes shining like a big blue flower. Back in me. Would you believe me if I said I promise
I'd never go this way? Alright. We have like 6 minutes and 30 seconds left. We're on pace to get at least 5, which is good. All right, back to rows. Let's get it.
And here we are, Dancing in the strobe light from the sky, just you and I. And our eyes shining like a deep blue, blue sea. We're fascinated. Would you believe me if I did? I promise I'll never break this away. And here we are, dancing in the strobe light from the sky, just you and I.
Oh, the lunges. Oh, my goodness. Minute, 5 seconds left. Mm-hmm. muscle. More seconds. Three, two, one. Good job. That's it. Done. Come.
Oh my gosh. Whew. It's a little bit sweaty. Good job, Carl. Whew. That was awesome.
That was good. I think I'll do.